you don't have a Webfile account, view our How to Create a Webfile Account video to learn how to sign up. If you already have an account, let's continue.
This video will take you through the process of making an electronic check payment. Payment by electronic check requires you to enter your banking information. With this option, you can file early and post-date your payment. Just change the payment effective date after you have entered your banking information. Now remember, you can pause this video at any time. Now let's get started. Once you have selected to file a return with a payment or make a payment only, you will arrive at the payment portal page. The payment portal page may reflect total tax due, balance due, and pending payments. Returns and payments that have not been completely processed will not be reflected. Please note, franchise tax account balances are not reflected in Webfile. A payment is not submitted at this point. You will be prompted for financial information and have the option to modify the payment amount after selecting Continue. Select the radio button next to Electronic Check and select Continue. If a return has been filed, the amount due will populate in the Amount to Pay box. Verify the payment amount is correct. If you need to make changes, you can adjust the amount of the payment in the Amount to Pay box. If a return has not been filed, you must enter an amount to pay. Franchise tax account balances are not reflected in Webfile. If you are making a payment only for sales tax or direct pay and the return has not been filed, you must enter the state and local amounts due. The amounts you enter will be combined for the total amount to pay on the summary page. Select either checking or savings for the type of bank account. Enter the 9-digit bank routing number and account number to be debited. You will need to re-enter the bank account number for verification. Your bank routing number and bank account number are located on the bottom of checks issued by your financial institution. Look in the lower left-hand corner of the check. This is the standard location for all routing numbers. The bank account number is typically located to the right of the bank routing number. The numbers listed on your deposit slip may be different from the numbers listed on the check and should not be used. Select the payment effective date. You can choose the payment effective date up to 30 days in advance, but make sure it's not later than the date the taxes are due. You may select payment options at any time to return to the payment options screen. The payment options screen provides the option to change a payment type or file a return without payment if a return is being filed. Select Agree and Continue. The Payment Portal Summary screen provides you with the ability to confirm the payment information is correct. You may select Edit to correct payment data or payment options to choose a different method of payment. Once a payment has been submitted, it cannot be amended or canceled. You must contact your financial institution to initiate a stop payment. Select Submit Payment to initiate your payment only, or to submit a return with payment. You will receive a confirmation page when you have successfully submitted your payment. It is very important to print or save this page for your records. If you are submitting a return with your payment, this will be reflected on the confirmation page. Once you have submitted your payment, you may review payment and return history by selecting Return to Menu. The View Return Summary option allows you to view the history for your electronic submissions. Select the radio button next to View Transaction History and select Continue. The View Transaction History screen will list all the returns and payments you submitted on your Webfile account. Payment processing times may vary. The typical processing time is 3 to 4 days. Payments reflect the submission date or payment effective date. If you need additional help, call 1-800-442-3453 or email webfile.help@cpa.texas.gov.